Is CrunchBang good for beginners?
It is good for old hardware, but it isn't as good for older users.
I'm not old.
CrunchBang is not good for new Linux users. Ubuntu, Mageia and Mint are better for newbies.
Ubuntu and Mint are better for new users than CrunchBang, since it is simply an improved version of Debian.
CrunchBang requires you to mount internal drives manually. That alone is about as bad as Debian's installation.
CrunchBang has a whole suite of software installed.
CrunchBang doesn't have a mail client installed, despite the criticality of email these days. It only has a Microsoft Word rival, no spreadsheet or PowerPoint.
What else do I need to know?
It is ultra-stable, and it is light on your operating system.
But you have to install basic apps to have a truly functional PC. That doesn't strike me as user-friendly, much less beginner-friendly.
And since it is based on Debian, it doesn't have the simple search for tools and install option.
At least it doesn't make me combine configuration files to update the OS.
That's true, that overarching cruelty is the legacy of the Arch Linux OS.
What are the weaknesses of CrunchBang?
Debian wants to limit you to drivers written by Debian developers, limiting its compatibility with various devices. CrunchBang causes similar device incompatibility problems with CD burners and so forth.
But CrunchBang does let you edit configuration files to fit the hardware and customize it as you see fit.
Newbies shouldn't be messing with configuration files, much less have to.
At least CrunchBang has install scripts and file repositories to simplify installations.
It's not as bad as Arch, where you install recipes of files and then merge them. But newbies need installations from a single file selection of a USB drive or updates at the touch of a button. And CrunchBang is too complicated for new users.